Our next guest has been busy since changing out of his scrubs on Grey's Anatomy. Now he's portraying one of the most iconic FBI leaders for the Nat Geo first scripted series, Genius. Welcome, T.R. Knight. How
are you? Thank
you
very much. Well, thank you for
having
me. Okay,
I'm so excited for you guys to see this.
Yes.
This transformation that he goes through for J. Edgar Hoover is unbelievable. How long did this take?
It took 5 hours.
Five hours every day.
Wow. Every day. Yeah, but I didn't. Yeah, you can see it there. There's a Davina Lamont is the head of the makeup and prosthetics.
Just wait till you see this. It is so incredible.
And that's Floris and Urin right now.
Okay.
That you see. There's also Sangeet, who's you don't see on this, and then there's Kate and Tosh, and then Davina.
And while we're watching this, how much does doing this help you get into character?
Well, I mean, I've never gotten to experience like this kind of.
Look at this!
You're watching them create it right there, which is, and just getting to see their, that's them taking it off. That was the only gross part.
Okay, how long
you feel like coming
that
out of
take?
A cocoon. About a half hour.
Were you tempted to keep it on?
Yeah.
Come back the next day.
Your skin doesn't need to breathe.
No, of course not. It was just, I mean, to watch them work is. I mean, it was just astounding to me. I
such
couldn't
artists.
Believe it. Yeah,
artists.
It really.
They're
artists.
It's so funny. Like, I'm sorry, didn't mean to interrupt you.
No, not at all.
We've all heard J. Edgar Hoover, and I had to go back and look up who he is. And you actually describe him as a monster. And set up who J. Edgar Hoover was and why you called him a monster.
He was the FBI. You know, he was the FBI before the FBI was the FBI. He was before when it was the Bureau of Investigations. He was the director, and then when it was founded, the official FBI during FDR. And he was FBI director until his death in 72. He was 77 years old.
And he used it for his personal.
He was a fanatic. Yeah. You know, he wanted to get rid of communism. He thought it was the evil, most monstrous thing to ever happen to man. And so when you have that fanaticism, he would do anything legally or not, violent or not, to get rid of it. So, only after his death did they find out how kind of insidious he was. But, you know, his hatred for Martin Luther King Jr., for the civil rights movement, for the Kennedys, for Einstein. It's just like anything that was, he viewed as subversive, and he would do anything to, and that's dangerous, because he was the most, arguably, I think, the most powerful person in the country during that time to sit through, you know, at least 8 presidents. Arguably, you could do 2 more. I keep on using that.
And they
word,
were scared arguably. Of him. And they were scared of him, right? That's why they didn't eliminate him.
Yeah, I mean, he had a lot of information, and he would share it in the idea of, just so you know, I found this. So I'm glad nobody else did, but just so you know, I have this. So he would accumulate all these secrets, but also just the violence with which he would, you know, want to carry out these eliminations was pretty frightening.
So not only was that transformation unbelievable, but when you see this clip, I was like goosebumps. Just listen to his voice. We have to take a look at a clip of Genius.
Men like Einstein confuse an unstable nation. And such confusion is as reprehensible and is as punishable as any other crime. So I found a way to punish him. This is it.
Your solution is to humiliate a man? To silence him?
Einstein has spoken out with impunity for years. It was time someone shoved a gag in that mouth.
Wow. PR, that is.
If you don't get an award for that, giving you. I thought that was so. I mean, we've been all talking about it all morning. Excited for you to come in because
thank you. That's so good.
So he really hated Einstein.
Yeah, yeah. No, and just to be able to get a chance to play someone like that, and it's just as an actor, it's just like. It's unbelievable. You feel like you constantly are showing up. You're on the flight out to Prague, and you're like, I hope I get there. And they're not like, oh, no, sorry, we made a mistake.
Well, I was thinking that because casting-wise, you'd think, they choose an actor closer to James.
Get an old guy.
Age.
Right. Well, he ages. You didn't see it there because that's the oldest you see him, but he does age 40 years. So I play him at the beginning, kind of the beginning of his career, and in it.
And how timely is this given everything with the FBI yesterday? They probably didn't even know that.
He mentioned him yesterday.
Yeah.
Not wanting to appear like You know what?
Yeah.
It's just, oh, that was
I didn't
fascinating.
Even catch that. Oh my God, this is amazing. Yeah, I love this. Yeah. Thank you so much for coming in, Genius.
Thanks for having me.
You're so welcome. Airs Tuesday at 9 p.m. on the National Geographic Channel. Phenomenal job.
Thank
amazing.
You. So
thank
much.
You,
GR.
Congratulations. Thank you. Coming up this morning. Did you have your first drink of alcohol before you hit the age of 15?
The alarming study now linked to getting drunk at a young age.